Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the bullpen. In the bullpen today, we have Mr. Sean Themea, commentator, Young Voices, and chief of staff for Young Americans for Liberty. He's been all over the place, Newsmax, OAN, et cetera, et cetera. Good to have you on the show, Sean. How are you?
I'm doing great, Dr. Richey. Thanks for having me back.
Absolutely, man. Thanks for coming back. Okay. We're going to talk about the all of a sudden about face that conservatives have displayed. They are now for defunding the police, contextualized through the agency known as the FBI. Interesting. I don't want to presume what you know, believe about this new found dynamic with the conservative party. So if you would, give us your sentiment and I would then opine.
Absolutely. Well, I love to see it. And I think that people are justified in distrusting the motives or intentions of the FBI raid of Donald Trump's home. Because if you know your history, you know that the Federal Bureau of Intimidation has been used and abused to crush political dissent and protect the elites since its founding. And defunding and abolishing the FBI, the case for it writes itself. You go back to the founding, World War I, when it was founded, Woodrow Wilson used it to arrest and spy on people who opposed sending troops to Europe. Fast forward a couple of decades, the FBI is blackmailing and sabotaging civil rights leaders like Dr. King, Malcolm X, who was even complicit in the murder of Viola Liuzzo, prominent civil rights activist. The Republicans used it in the 80s to spy on hundreds of organizations who opposed the regime change and involvement of the intelligence agencies in Latin America. In the past two decades after the Patriot Act, I mean, it's gotten worse than ever. Unprecedented power to wiretap and spy on American citizens without warrants, to put them on no-fly lists, freeze their bank accounts without due process. And now we see it coming to a head where they're going and raiding a former president's home and spying on him during his campaign. That is waking up a lot of people. And the legitimate functions of the FBI really could be done at the state level when it comes to criminal investigations. So okay, my thoughts, and I'm glad to see conservatives see, as Anthony Sabatini would put it, I think we need to gut this agency like a fish and get power back to the people.
All right, so let me respond to that. First of all, let me say for the record, I have no love for the FBI. They are the police. I will let them defend themselves. And for black people, we're in a precarious situation because we have feckless state prosecutors who are unwilling to prosecute obvious crimes like the death of Breonna Taylor. And then the DOJ comes in and does what the state agency chose not to do under Republican leadership. And you're right, they put Dr. King under surveillance. They made him enemy number one. And this list goes on to people like Malcolm X and others. So we don't have some kind of cozy relationship with the FBI, black people historically. So I want to make sure I say that for the record. But I do find it interesting, and you must also find it ironic, that we've been telling you all for decades that police agencies, FBI included, need to reprioritize their budgets in order to fix or affix a criminal justice dynamic that's known as what? Public safety. That the goal, the aim should have always been public safety, not policing. Not arrest, not simple investigation, but public safety. You all said we were wrong. When we said defund the police, you all said we were wrong, that we were anti-police. We're anti-bad police, just like you would say you're anti-bad FBI. But let's be very clear. On your social media, sir, you now have a tagline. You say defund the FBI, am I correct?
Yes, sir.
When did you put it up?
Well, I put it up right when it was hot and when people would start accepting the message a little more.
When did you put it up?
I put up defund the FBI a couple weeks ago, and 2 years ago, after George Floyd was killed, my organization went out and we provided solutions as how we could reform the police.
Wait a minute.
Things like this from happening, qualified immunity, ending that, ending no-knock warrants.
Oh, I'm with you. I'm with you.
I'm a libertarian. I think we agree a lot more.
Yeah, we actually do connect in some areas, and we discussed that before. But you recently put up defund the FBI. Now, are you willing to join me and say we need to defund the police?
I think we need some real police reform. I do think we need to end qualified immunity. I think we need to end police militarization.
Wait a minute, brother. You can say defund the FBI. Cool, no problem. We need to reprioritize policing budgets in the FBI. I'm good with that. Are you willing to also say defund the police?
I prefer defund the police state. I think militarized police is a great problem. I mean, these people have tanks, these people are abusing rights, And I think that that's a problem. I think that the police state as a whole is a greater issue. And you see defund the police though being targeted with a lot of proposals that don't actually defund the police as much as they do reprioritize budgets and have that spending go toward some programs that are somewhat specious and that I don't necessarily think will fix the problem. So I'm happy to say defund the police state, as I think that encompasses, you know, the whole issue.
Do you think it's telling that we are now somewhat in agreement that police offices, police divisions have been utilized in an adversarial manner against humanity? Now, when we said it was happening to black folks, you all didn't ride with us. Now, all of a sudden that it happens to one rich, well-connected white man known as Donald Trump, all of a sudden you all start posting defund the police or defund the FBI on your social media. So it took one white man to get raided by the FBI, which likely is a credible raid, in order for you all to realize that when we said black bodies being shot by cops, unarmed black people being killed by the police should warrant a defunding of those police departments and reprioritizing their budgets. You all said that we were antithetical to police, that we were antithetical to law and order, that we were adversarial to the United States of America. So why is it that you all get to enjoy a narrative of being patriots when you say defund the FBI, but when Black Lives Matter said defund the police, you all said that we were somehow antithetical to the movement of the country?
Well, you say this you all phrase, I'm not sure this you all is. I'm a libertarian. My organization came out strong for ending qualified immunity, for ending no-knock warrants, for making internal matters external. I mean, there is plenty we can do for police reform. And the greater threat, the bigger threat that affects all of us, I think, is the concentration of police military power in DC, as we see from the FBI's history. So, you know, you can talk to Marjorie Taylor Greene about what she thinks, but I'll speak for myself. Now, and Marjorie Taylor Greene and Bernie Sanders' press secretary are in agreement right now about defunding the FBI.
And Sean, listen to me, brother. I appreciate you because I think you come from an authentic place. I'm just challenging you because you do rock with some conservative folks on some things here, all right? And the conservative movement, which, you know, libertarians, you all have some significantly conservative tendencies and friends. The conservative movement has now said, we must defund the FBI. Cool, reprioritize the budget, that's fine. But over Donald Trump, so you gotta think about this. One, if the man was holding on to classified information that he did not have any business having, and he was told to turn it over and chose not to, how do we get those documents back? How does the government get those documents back? You tell me.
I think we could work with that from a robust police presence at the state level. That's not going to be in
the
hands the
state
of
police?
One person in DC.
Wait,
that's the problem.
You're saying the state police should have gone up into Mar-a-Lago? You think DeSantis would have approved that? You think his state director would have approved going into Donald Trump's home and grabbing those classified documents? That's what you believe?
We'd have to see. All I know is that we're setting a precedent
no good
in 2024 when Trump or DeSantis comes back to wield the FBI against their political opponents. And that's not good. That's a big threat.
All right. So listen, man, I do appreciate you coming on the show. I wish we had a little more time. I got to go to the next show.
Sure.
But always, you come from an authentic place, and I appreciate you, brother. Thank you so much for coming.
Back at you. Great to be here.